In this guide video, I'll show you guys 4 different ways on how to round a corner in Inkscape. The aim of this video is to explore the software capabilities, and in the end, I'll give you guys my opinion on which one is the best. So make sure to give your opinion too. Alright, the first one is on how to round an object corner in Inkscape is to use the rectangle properties over here. So let's just create an arbitrary rectangle like this, and I'm gonna give it a black color. And if we go to the notes tool over here, we can actually round the corner of the rectangle itself like this. And as you see, it's pretty much flexible and it's looking pretty good for us. And if we do the same thing with this rectangle over here, we can actually have it like this. And you'll notice that we have this Rx and Ry on the context menu bar. And that is the radius of the corner itself. So let's just change the corner radius to 100 on the Ry. And the same thing on the Rx, maybe 80. And as you see, we can round this corner as well. And we have something pretty much like this to round a corner. And it works really well as well if you create a square like this. And if I just make it sharp like this, and I've just round the corner like that, and just maybe increase the radius a bit, and it's looking pretty good. But the caveat of this is that it just works on a rectangle. If you use something like a triangle, for example, over here I'm going to create a triangle like this. The triangle doesn't have that ability, because as you see over here, we have the corners around it, but not the corner around it, just the sides. And you might want to create something like this, but most of the time, no. And randomize, and we can't really change the corner radius. The same thing if you go to the nose tool, nothing really works as well. And another thing right now is that if we convert this object, all of this object into a path, so go to the path, object to path, and if we go to the nodes tool over here, you'll notice that we already have this kind of nodes that we cannot change the radius of. Alright, the next one is by utilizing the stroke or the outline feature in Inkscape. So I have these 3 objects over here. I'm going to show you guys the case. The first one is on the left over here, which is the line. I'm going to zoom in, and as you see, you have this line over here that I wanted to have something like a fully rounded corner of a rectangle in this object over here. Because if I do that with a rectangle like this, and if I, you know, fully rounded it and give it a color, you'll notice that we have something that fully rounded like this, and that's what I really want. And I want to have the same thing with this one. And the way you can do that is by selecting this one over here and open up the fill and stroke panel, and under stroke style, we can change the cap into a round cap. And if I change that, you'll notice that we have this radius as well as this one, the same thing as this one. And that's what we essentially really want. The next thing that you can do that is by utilizing this outline feature with this rectangle over here. So I want to have a round rectangle, rounded corner rectangle on this square over here. And if I add a fill to this, and I'm gonna change the cap as well as the joint into a round joint, as well as the round cap. And as you see, we have this rounded corner over here. And if we increase the width of the outline like this, you'll notice that we have more of a rounded corner like this. And if I move to the right over here, I have this text that says button, and I'm gonna round the corner behind it, which is an outline like this, by, you know, rounding the cap like that, and we have this sense of a button, just like a rectangle. Alright, the next one is actually my favorite. By utilizing the add corner LPE feature, and we can actually create a rounded corner, which is really flexible. And the way to do that is they have 2 ways you can access it. The first one is I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to select this rectangle over here, and I'm going to go to the nodes tool. And as you see, we have this icon over here that's add corner LPE. And once you select that, we have this a bunch of nodes that we can create too. And if you just drag this circle nodes over here, you'll notice that we have a rounded corner. And we have this triangle over here that we can work with, and that is pretty much really good. It's really flexible, because as you see, I can have a really difference, a radius all around. And that's one of the biggest strengths of this feature over here. And the way you can access it as well is, I'm going to select this over here by going to the path effects, and I'm going to add the corner pad effects like that, and we have something like this, which is essentially the same. If I go to the notes tool over here, it's actually just the same. If I select this over here, as you see, the corner pad effects panel is still open up, which is they're essentially the same. One of the great feature of this thing is you can actually select all of them and just increase the radius like this to create a consistent look. The way you can do that as well is if I hold shift and click one of the triangle over here, I can actually change the individual value as well as individual style of it. So if I select this one over here, the inverse fillet, and this one is the fillet, and this one's gonna be the inverse fillet, and if I click modify, you'll see that I have the inverse, which is the inside, which is kind of inside part like this, and that is super super awesome. And once you done with that, you can just go to the path, object to path, or by this drop down over here, go to flatten like that. And if you want to add another corner pad effects, you can actually do that by adding it again, corner pad effects. And if I just do something like it again, we can have another radius, which is really really efficient and flexible, and it's super awesome. You can add it more and more as long as there is a sharp corner, or just you want to add more of a rounded corner like this. Alright, lastly my friend, I'm gonna show you guys on how to round a corner by using object referencing or the manual way in Inkscape. There's two ways you can do this. The first one is by utilizing the boolean feature or the boolean operation feature in Inkscape, and the second one is by utilizing the shape builder tool, which is the new feature in Inkscape 1.3. So I'm gonna show you guys the first one, which is the boolean operations. So first of all, you want to select this circle over here, just the circle, Control plus D to duplicate it, and back and make it into a red color like this, just momentarily. And then I'm gonna hold shift and click on the square behind it and go to the path, difference, go to the path, break apart, to break it apart into two individual objects like this. And you want to take out this object over here, just this one, and press delete on the keyboard to get rid of that. And then you want to select both of them, both of the circle, as well as the, you know, object we have done the boolean operation before, and go to the path, union. So we have this a square that has a rounded corner, a corner radius on one of it. And if you go to the nodes over here, you'll notice that we have a lot of excess nodes that we have to get rid of. So let's just get rid of it like this. And now it's pretty much done, and that's looking pretty good. Or the next one, I'm going to show you guys on how to do that with the shape builder tool. So first of all, you want to select both of them and go to the shape builder tool over here. And we have these two modes, the add and the delete mode. I'm going to do one with the add mode over here, and you want to make one object on this area as well as in this area. So hold left click and just drag it in to the circle, so we have something like this. And then you want to go to the delete mode and just select this over here to get rid of it, so we have something that has similar like before, and just click finish to done that. And we have two similar object, which is the object referencing or manual way on how to round a corner. So we have tried four different ways to round a corner. And we all have the same question here, which is better? Even which is the best? Well, in my opinion, it all comes down to these two. Why? The only reason for these two on the top is because they are, first, precise. You can round the corner exactly how you want it on any shape. Second is extensive. You can give the shape mean radius as you want regarding the shape. And how are they different? Corner LPE is efficient while object referencing is not. You can add radius quickly on corner LPE than the other, because object referencing needs human precision to calculate the radius and positions. Also, remember when I mentioned precise? Well, in case of corner LPE, not exactly, compared to object referencing, as you see on the screen. If you compare it to a circle, you'll notice that corner LPE doesn't follow the shape really well. Or maybe this is just a case on my machine, let me know yours. Lastly, the education that you can get from object referencing is invaluable. I remember when I was designing a corner before the corner LPE added to Inkscape. I learned a lot of shape and able to visualize it just using a simple shape. I suggest you use it often if you are a beginner. So, the case scenario. Corner LPE is suited for designing an object that needs radius quickly and lacks precision a bit. Like illustration, Well, object referencing suited for something like logo design because how precise it is and how you can construct it back. So that's the ways to run a corner of an object in Inkscape. Hopefully, you can learn something new in this video. Let me know if you guys have more tips in Inkscape and let me know for more guides in Inkscape. As always, thank you for your time.